finding the correct size cello is probably the single most consequential gift that you can give yourself in terms of your ease of playing the cello, your enjoyment of playing the cello, and eventually your success in playing the cello. So think about that before you head to the rental shop to rent an instrument or perhaps even to buy an instrument. And I'm Carolyn Hagler with CelloDiscovery.com, the online website for sequential learning. And in this video, I'm gonna teach you how to find the right size cello for you. So for starters, cello sizes come in the following sizes. They come in the 1/8 size, they come in the 1/4 size, and then they come in the half size, the 3/4 size, the 7/8 size, and the 4/4, which is also known as the full size cello. The smallest three sizes are usually reserved for children because they're the smallest instruments. Adult sizes usually begin at the 3/4, and the largest three sizes really do need to be part of your consideration, not just the 4/4 size, not just the full size cello. Let me begin with a quick note to women cellists out there, and maybe some guys who tend to be a little bit smaller. When you go to the rental shop, there is a tendency to size adults in a 4/4 size cello, a full size cello. And that's because the bulk of the inventory, which most rental shops have in stock, tend to be that size. So it's available for you to take home that day. But in addition, there tends to be this misconception that if you're an adult, you need to play on a full size cello. 7/8 cellos are a little bit harder to find, but there's been a movement by people like me and others out there who really feel like people need to be educated better and have a size that fits somebody better. It's a lot easier now to find a 7/8 cello than it was maybe even 10 years ago. And if you're even smaller, a 3/4 size cello is going to be right for you, and there's lots of those available. So what is the most important factor that you should consider when getting sized for a cello? It's your hand size. Your hand size is number one, and try not to let anybody else convince you otherwise. If they do, it's probably safe to assume that they haven't had training on how to size a beginning cellist, or they're just a big person with big hands and they probably just don't get it. There are three components to hand size. The first is the girth of the palm. And the second is the length of the fingers. And the third is the uniqueness or the agility of the fingers. And what I mean by that is maybe you have your double jointed and your fingers collapse. Maybe you have a strange bend in one of your fingers, or maybe you have one finger that's just exceptionally shorter than another finger. Well, that's a uniqueness that you have that you need to factor in. So those three factors work in conjunction with each other when determining your instrument size. For example, if you have a narrow palm but really long fingers, the long fingers are going to compensate for the narrow palm. But if you have a narrow palm and short fingers, it's safe to assume that you have a small hand and you should probably be playing on a small cello. When we talk about finger length, and that's assuming that you don't have any truly unique finger sizes, it's the fourth finger that usually causes a bit of trouble. The fourth finger is required to extend, and in some of the positions, there's a rather large extension that the hand needs to make. An extension is just a stretch. And if you have long fingers, your stretch will be comfortable on a full-size cello. But if you have shorter fingers or a shorter, smaller palm, that stretch is going to be very difficult in some of the positions. And it's probably going to even hurt your hand just by trying. And that's why you need to have a smaller cello. So the smaller the cello, the shorter the fingerboard, and the easier the stretch. So that gives you some information to consider, but how do you apply that information when determining what size cello you need to rent or purchase? So my key piece of advice is to always err on the smaller side. Some professionals kind of poo-poo that idea, and it's usually those people that play on a full-size cello because they say that the sound of a 7/8 cello just cannot compete with that of a full-size. And there is a bit of truth to that, but because all instruments are different or unique, if you pair that instrument with a different set of strings or a different bow, then you have a ton of different options for getting the optimal projection out of your cello. And additionally, you know, so what? I mean, you are an adult beginner and you are doing this for you. And if you aren't planning on hitting the stage as a professional soloist with an orchestra, then a huge projection really isn't that important. The quality of your sound is much more important than the quantity of your sound. So as a starting point, figure out what size glove you wear and use the men's sizing charts regardless of your gender, because that's how we can work with an equal playing field. And if you fit into a men's large or extra large glove size, go with a full size cello, because a smaller cello is probably going to be a lot more difficult for you to play. But if you fit into a men's medium glove size, and you're probably going to be good with a 7/8 or a full size cello. And if you fit into a men's small size glove, then definitely go with the 7/8 size cello. I hope this was helpful to you, but if you still have a question, maybe there's something really unique about your hand size, and you're still not sure what size to pick, feel free to leave me a comment in the comments field below, and I'll make sure that I get back to you on that. And if you like this video and you look forward to seeing more educational cello videos or cello performance videos, feel free to subscribe to my channel below, and don't forget to hit the like button. And thanks again, and I'll see you next time.